So, next up, you load the kiln, ready to do your first kiln fire. I let these dry for about 7 days before I put them in the kiln to make sure they're bone dry. So today you will be glazing your clay license plate. As you can see, we fired them in the kiln and they changed colors. The dark red clay turned orange and the gray clay turned white. And as you can hear, now they're rock hard. Of course, if you drop them, they will break. So when they're in this state, it's called a bisque fire. The clay has been bisque fired. You're gonna start with your color for your sky and your lettering, just like on your marker design. Okay, so I would be starting with orange. Now, some of you did this where you have the two colors of clay, and instead of having to glaze orange and orange in the letters and then gray, you only have to glaze one color, because we don't want to cover up this cool looking different color. So you can choose either to leave your red clay and glaze the mountains, or to leave the white clay and cover the mountains and the woods. I would probably, like mine, I'm gonna leave the red clay. I like the way that this is called terracotta. I like the way that looks, and I'm just gonna paint the rest gray. But let's look at this one, because most of us have one like this that's just all white clay, and we need to make the color differentiation. Here's our glaze. This stuff's very expensive. This can here costs $16.50. So please do not be wasteful with it. So we're not wasteful with it, we will keep it in a little cup here so it doesn't dry out too much. This one was from last year, so it's gonna be pretty dry. So I'm just gonna put a tad bit of water in there, and then we'll add some fresh glaze and it should mix itself back up. Yeah. Glaze goes through a chemical change. When we fire it again in the kiln, it will go from this dull color to a bright, shiny color. And that is caused by the heat, okay? So, a couple things. You guys are old enough that you can just read this and know jack-o'-lantern means it's orange. But for the little kids, and I do it to help, it helps everybody. We put the orange glaze on orange paper so you know what color you're glazing with. There are some glazes, when you paint them on, they might look a total different color than what they turn out when we fire them. This one, it looks a dull, kind of boring orange. When I fire it, it's gonna turn out a bright orange that will look like a pumpkin. That's why it's named jack-o'-lantern. So what we wanna concentrate on today is your letters and your mountains, okay? And we'll be glazing that first. I got a little too much water in here. Let me thin that out.
You have about 2 minutes.
Okay. So it's not recording?
If it runs out, we'll just stop. Oops. And do another take. I think I might have. So anyways, you want to go in and you want to do 3 coats of glaze. So I'm going to come into the letters and I need to paint this 3 times. And it dries very quickly because the clay is actually sucking up the moisture in the glaze. Do not get it in the wrong place. If I accidentally get a drop of orange up where it should be gray, I need to stop and get a sponge and clean that out. If you leave it on there, the orange and the gray glaze will mix together and make a funky new color that we don't want. So just go in, get everything painted with 3 coats of glaze. Now I want to show you a trick with the Colorado to make the fine lines of the Colorado look really good. That, the word Colorado is going to be orange just like my other words. And what I'd like you to do is go in with the smallest brush you can find and go in and paint Colorado, and it's going to seep out the sides a little bit. That's okay. I'll show you why in a minute. And same as usual, you need to paint that with three coats so that the glaze is really thick. If you make only one or two coats, your glaze will be semi-transparent, meaning that it will still look orange, but we'll be able to see back through it and see the clay that's underneath it. So I'd go in and I'd paint this with three coats, and then when it's dry, I'll show you how we're going to clean it up before we add the gray. Okay, on the mountains, while we're letting that dry, let's look at the sky above the mountains. Above the mountains, you want to do the same thing. You're going to paint it all orange, but then you also want to paint the edge of your license plate. Be careful here. When you're holding it up with one hand, you don't want it to break under its own weight. So you paint the mountains and the edge. How many layers of glaze do you do?
Three.
Try and not get it on the back. I got a little bit on the back and I can clean that off later. But the reason why is when we put this in the kiln, the glaze turns into, like I said, a liquid glass, almost like a hot lava, maybe, a molten glass. And that, when it's cooling down, it will stick to anything it's touching. So if it's only touching our license plate, it only sticks to the license plate. If it's on the back of our license plate, it's gonna stick to the kiln. And that's a big problem, okay? So anyways, back to the Colorado here. I painted my Colorado. I really got it down into the lines that are the impression or the depression that spell Colorado. Now what I want to do is I want to clean off the extra. So I take a damp sponge. It can't be soaking wet, David. It has to be damp. And I just want to go over that and clean it up. And what's happening is the wetness is only touching the top layer of the clay. It's not scrubbing down inside the letters. Okay, so now I've got it so the orange is only down in the letters and the top is nice and clean for when I paint gray. Okay, and that's all we're gonna do today. If for some reason you do get this far where all of your letters are done with three coats, all of your Colorado is done with three coats, and all of your sky and the edges of the sky are done with three coats, then you may paint the tags. My tags were yellow and purple and blue and green, okay? Questions about glazing? Most important thing is don't get it on the back. Don't get it in places where it doesn't want to be. So orange only goes where orange is. We made these whole maps, so you know that. And three layers of glaze everywhere you paint today. Okay, great.